how did you enter the industry, and what was your hack, or what was your way, or what do you think is important for people to enter into the industry from an insider's perspective? Let's talk about that a little bit.
So as an actor, I'll tell you very honestly how I started. I used to do theater a lot in Delhi.
Okay.
From college days till today, I still do theater. So when I was doing theater, I used to just, you know, there are so many groups on Facebook and Instagram and everything. Of course, there are fake ones as well. But there are so many groups now, Dilawas, that people post auditions on. And that time also, okay, it was a new trend. So once I remember that I went for an audition very randomly, and it was for a film. I wasn't even sure if this film is going to release or whatever, or it's fake, or I didn't know. But I still used to go for these auditions every now and then. Some were fake, some were nice. I got some commercials in Delhi while I was in college. So there was this one film I was auditioning for, and I got the part. The director was so impressed by me that he's like, oh, you know, I'm going to cast you as one of the characters for sure. But I thought it's fake. So I was a little scared also. I was 18 years old. My mother went on set with me and everything. But it turned out to be a great experience for me. So all those people who are watching, I would say that keep your eyes open on these audition groups. There are fake ones as well. But if you want to, you know, somehow, it's not that you have to first and foremost come to Mumbai and start looking. You can start in your own city as well. Nowadays, I think because of this COVID situation, there are more ads and, you know, shoots happening in different parts of the world, country.
Right.
Like, Delhi mein kitna kuch ho raha hai. So I really feel that you should just keep looking for these production houses.
Hi, Kanisha. How are you?
Hi, Dilawas. How are you? I'm good.
I'm good. Thank you for coming on Cracking the Code. And this is our fifth episode. Absolutely. So guys, all those who are watching, Kanisha is an Indian television actress. She's a model. She's a stylist. She's a director. She's a script writer and producer. She is a lifestyle influencer. She has worked in multiple web series, right from shows like CID to a couple of prominent shows on ZTV. She has been all over the place. And then she has also done and tried her hand into directing. And she also runs a very successful YouTube channel where she does product reviews. If I can add one more thing, Kanisha is a successful Instagram influencer, and she really is one of the best in the country, where she works with more than 150 plus brands, right from Amazon to Nike to likes of those. And I'm sure I'm very excited to talk about your entire journey, that, you know, what you have able to accomplish, and you're able to wear all these hats in past couple of years. So yeah, happy to have you here, Kanisha, and once again, welcome to Cracking the Code.
That was a great introduction, and I'm really happy to be here, as I said.
So, Kanisha, let me start with the first question, right? How do you do all this stuff? How do you manage to do all this stuff? Because this is not just, I would rather say these are not just multiple roles, but multiple industries and multiple skill sets, which require a lot of learning and a lot of backing. So how do you do what you do? Let's talk about that first.
So, Dilawas, I always wanted to explore new things, and I've been a kind of a person who doesn't sit at one place. So even if I'm at my office, I can't sit at one place. I need to explore. Like, if there's a social media team, I need to go and ask them, what are you doing? So I'm that curious kid who always wants to learn new things. So that's how I realized that, this is not one thing I want to do. I want to keep learning and exploring different industries and different things. So that's how, and I know it's difficult to juggle from here and there, but somehow I enjoy it. That hustle is really important for me to be alive, to be honest. So that's how I do it. I enjoy actually doing different things.
So you are a curious hustler kid, or a hustler curious kid, if I may put it that way.
Correct.
And if I'm not wrong, you are originally from Delhi.
I'm originally from Delhi.
Does that make 7 years? How many years back?
7 years back.
7 years back. So does that Delhi thing make you a little more curious? Is that the Delhiite in you, which is a hustler, which is a more curious person?
Not at all. There are so many Delhiites I've seen who come to Mumbai and they pack their bags and go back. for a reason that they don't want to hustle, they don't want to work hard towards it. For me, it's like, if I'm not able to succeed in one place, I don't want to stop there. I want to keep exploring new perspectives and new eras for me, so that when I grow old, I can tell my kids I don't have any regrets in life.
Okay, so Kanisha, let's now talk about where this all started. So, you know, I know you have been doing all this stuff. So where did your journey kind of begin from? What was the inception point and what motivated you to be in this space?
So I was 10 years old when my parents have been really curious as well, because they themselves did not get to do things they wanted to do in life. So I remember there was this audition happening in Delhi for a TV show on DD1. I was 10 years old and my mother got to know from somewhere and she's like, "Are, tujhe TV mein acting karni hai kya?" So I was like, "Are, matlab haan." I was a very shy kid that time, but I always wanted to, you know, act. So I was 10 years old, my mother took me for an audition and I killed it. I got the part and I was a star overnight, and I just went to every door to door to my neighbors, telling them ki main na TV pe aane wali hu to mujhe dekhna. So that was the day I decided that when I grow up, people say modest things ki nahi nahi mujhe to kuch aur banna tha life mein, but I say it with passion and pride that I wanted to be an actor since I was 10 years old, and that's what I followed. That's what got me here in Mumbai. But I think that was not all for me. I wanted to do little more, explore more. So yeah, that's how it started when I was 10. After that that one show, I stopped acting because my mother somehow thought that it's affecting my studies. And because I was a very I was not a multitasker back then. I was very chanchal man wale bacche jo hote hain jinka man ek jagah se dusri jagah uchalta hai, to fir then it doesn't come back. So I started failing in my exams, and my mother realized it. So she's like, you know, once you grow up, do whatever. So I became a very shy kid because of that. I was always into my books till 10th standard. And in 10th, I remember there was a friend of my mother who told her, you know, why don't you put her for acting classes or something? So that's when I started, and I was really fat back then. So I started doing theater, and I played Vibhishana from Ramayana.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, so so that's how I got back to theater, and since 10th standard, there's no looking back since then.
How did you enter the industry, and what was your hack, or what was your way, or what do you think is important for people to enter into the industry from an insider's perspective? Let's talk about that a little bit.
So as an actor, I'll tell you very honestly how I started. I used to do theater a lot in Delhi.
Okay.
From college days till today, I still do theater. So when I was doing theater, I used to just, you know, there are so many groups on Facebook and Instagram and everything. Of course, there are fake ones as well. But there are so many groups now, Dilnawaz, that people post auditions on. And that time also, it was a new trend. So once I remember that I went for an audition very randomly, and it was for a film. I wasn't even sure if this film is going to release or whatever, or it's fake, or I didn't know. But I still used to go for these auditions every now and then. Some were fake, some were nice. I got some commercials in Delhi while I was in college. So there was this one film I was auditioning for, and I got the part. The director was so impressed by me that he's like, "Oh, you know, I'm gonna cast you as one of the characters for sure." But I thought it's fake. So I was a little scared also. I was 18 years old. My mother went on set with me and everything. But it turned out to be a great experience for me. So all those people who are watching, I would say that keep your eyes open on these audition groups. There are fake ones as well. But if you want to, you know, somehow, it's not that you have to first and foremost come to Mumbai and start looking. You can start in your own city as well. Nowadays, I think because of this COVID situation, there are more ads and, you know, shoots happening in different parts of the world, country.
Right.
Like Delhi mein kitna kuch ho raha hai. So I really feel that you should just keep looking for these production houses. And one more thing I would like to suggest is Google all the nice agencies and production houses in your own city. Go and drop in your photographs or drop in your audition links. If you don't have an audition link, make one. Just say a monologue, record it on your phone and drop it. You never know, you might get a chance. And if you feel that you have little potential as well, then you should definitely come and try in Mumbai, because of course it's the hub. But not right now, after the COVID situation subsides.
Of course. How important is this theater component in any and in everything you do, especially from the aspiring actor actress's point of view?
I think theater is a very important part, Dilnawaz, because it gives you confidence. It gives you that you know, that key and how to act and how to take care of your body, like how to control your body. Theater gives you that. Plus, theater gives you a lot of contacts. If it's a commercial play you're doing, there are so many people coming and watching you. I have seen so many actors getting work because of doing commercial plays. For my own theater, I used to work with this theater group called Films and Theater Society. And now they've started making commercial plays, and Mahesh Bhatt and Subhash Ghai and some such big name come to see their shows. So if you're if they're sitting in crowd and you're watching and you are on the stage and people are watching you, I think you're the star. It's in itself. And there are so many people, I'll tell you, they just say ki hame to TV karna hai, hame to fame chahiye. There's a huge difference. You need to understand, if you want to be an actor, you want to be a star. If you want to be an actor, you need to do theater because it gives you your roots. If you want to be a star, then you can just be a star. You can just get your fame, and then you won't be an artist. If you want to be an artist, you need to learn. And I think theater is the best way to learn. Everybody I know, especially in my theater group, everybody is doing so good right now, even if they're not actors. But they know how to talk and they know how to, you know, explain things to their customers, to people. So even if you're not an actor, if you do theater, it teaches you a lot. So I would just suggest everybody who wants to be an artist or somebody who has a passion for acting, you should do theater no matter what line you are in. Even Dilnawaz can do it, and I'm sure he will be great in it because he's a great anchor.
Thanks for the compliment. Thanks for the compliment, Karisha. How different is life from in front of the camera to behind the camera? How different is the life?
So I wanted to survive in Mumbai somehow. And I got an offer, you know, why don't you work as an assistant director? I knew a little about it because I'm, as I said, I'm a curious child. So I've learned a little here and there. But I was not sure how to go about it. So I still thought, okay, why not? Chalo kar lete yaar. I've done this and that, I should do this as well. It will be like a feather in my hat. So I did, you know, I started working as an assistant director in Ram Gopal Varma sir's film. It's called Virappan. In 2016. And Dilnawaz, I just, I was so tortured. I mean, I was tortured on set, literally. Somebody who's always on screen and who's always being pampered, as they say, like, on set, ma'am, ye kha lo, ma'am, wo kha lo. That person has to literally fetch water for actors. That person literally had to do things. Subha 4 baje utke, raat ko 12 baje so rahe ho. So I was exhausted. Not like they were torturing me, but I was tortured in myself. But somehow I started enjoying it. You know, that that just. And when I got back, after I finished this film, I got another TV show within like 4 days. And that, that transformation was so important for me as a person. I could actually understand the importance of being on screen then. So it actually helped me as an artist, and I learned so much that I got a passion for making films. So then I started juggling from being on screen to behind the scene, and that's how I started,
Okay. So Karisha, let's talk about some skill sets here now. So what do you think are the most critical skill sets that people need to maybe learn pre-hand? Because a lot of people want to now explore conventional careers. So somebody wants to maybe get into any of the domains behind the screen, maybe into production or maybe into art or into direction, something like that. What are the critical skill sets people need to learn beforehand, and how can they learn that?
Okay, so first and foremost, the most important thing for you to become an actor or an influencer is you should be a go-getter. You should be an opportunist. Because it's like out of sight, out of mind. You have to go get the work. People will not, of course, they will come to you after a certain period of time. But the first and foremost, the most important thing is you should know how to talk. You should know how to get your work done. You should know how to be an opportunist. For being a director or a filmmaker, you need to have some certain set of skills, like you need to learn the techniques. Like, people will not give you work until and unless you have no knowledge about techniques. So direction kaise karna hai, like, I did not go to film school. So I learned on set. So तो डायरेक्शन कैसे करना है, कौन सी चीज का ध्यान रखना है, यू नीड टू लर्न सर्टेन सेट ऑफ स्किल्स देयर. फॉर दैट यू कैन गो टू अ स्कूल, यू कैन वॉच फिल्म्स, यू कैन लर्न ऑन सेट एज वेल. तो माय सजेशन वुड बी दैट वॉच वीडियोस ऑनलाइन एंड वॉच फिल्म्स व्हिच इंट्रीग्स यू, व्हिच गिव यू इंटरेस्ट. यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द angles. If you want to be a director, you will understand the story. Try to write down 5 things you liked about the film and 5 things you didn't like about the film, and try to think about it. And that
okay.
is the skill you really need to be a filmmaker. But if you want to be an actor, if you want to be a performer, you should know how to speak first of all. Like your aura should be that people want you. Arey, isko lena hai, no matter what. Even if you can't become an actor, because there are so many things as in an actor, like you should look a particular way, you should fit the character. You can be a content creator, you can be an anchor, you can be so many things. It's just that you need to figure out what you want to do. And for that, you need to understand your set of skills. So yeah, be a go-getter.
Is there a way people can learn the skill online, or are there three things you can tell the audience that, hey, these are things you should look for or learn about?
As I said, watch videos, try to figure out the videos. You can find something online. There are so many courses on some nice apps also. I'm forgetting the names. This Coursera, there is Shaw Academy, there's another one. I'm just forgetting the name. There are so many nice apps these days which have these courses free of cost or a nominal price. You can just watch one of those platforms, and you can just take one of those courses to understand the basics of it. And as I'm talking about learning skills as an artist or as an influencer, I would suggest watch these people who are already doing things. Try to understand their body language. Try to understand what kind of content they create. Like, for example, I learned as an influencer. If you see my content, which was 1 year back, and if you see my content now, you will see a huge difference. I have learned the skills of, and as an artist, never stop. That's my one thing I want to say, never ever stop. Always try to explore your skills. Always try to, just try to learn new things every now and then. Always evolve. Never stop.
Absolutely. So let's talk about a few learnings and failures or critical learnings that you had during your journey. Let's talk about that a bit.
Wrong thing I've done in my life is I have spent a lot of my years in one thing.
Okay.
In 2016, I started switching. But till then, I was only focusing on acting.
Okay.
So my suggestion to everybody out there is give yourself only 2 years. If you don't make it big in 2 years, or if you don't get a good project in 2 years, switch your line. The biggest thing you need right now is a successful career, but also money to survive. If you don't have money, nobody will support you. So you need to literally have that in your pocket. Today, if you have money, the people will be with you. They will not elsewise. So do not waste more time on one particular set of skills. If you can make it, well enough. Give your best. For those 2 years, give yourself to it. Dedicate. Don't lose your focus. But if you can't, then please switch. Because I have done that. I myself have been rejected so many times, saying I'm not fit as an actor because I look a certain way. I'm tall and I'm broad. Usually in films and TVs, they want skinny. Now web has come, so the perception has changed. I've done a few web series myself. But till then, I was always seen as a person who can probably fit in a police inspector's role, or she's tall, or a doctor's role. They will never cast me as a homely wife or a homely mom sort of a role, because I don't look a certain part, right?
Okay.
So that perception was always there, and I have been rejected so many times. I was in depression for a long time, but I did not let it affect me much. And the worst part was that every time I was hitting the rock bottom, I told myself, no, you need to do something else in life. So that you have to survive this city is difficult to live in Dilnawaz.
absolutely
Mumbai, whosoever, this is my one suggestion to everybody who wants to come to Mumbai and work. I'm not demotivating you, but this city is very hard to live in, so maybe mentally, physically, emotionally and monetarily prepared if you come here.
So how do you survive in Mumbai? Let's talk about that. three tips from Kanisha Malhotra, how to survive Mumbai for a struggling, aspiring actor or director or producer, anybody who wants to get into what you do right now. Give me three tips. So we'll name it Kanisha Malhotra's three tips of survive for surviving Mumbai. Go ahead, Kanisha.
Okay. First of all whenever you come here, keep your tantrums at home. Don't get
okay.
tantrums. You will have to compromise a lot here before you can have your own 2 BHK flat in a nice area. Like I have, touch wood, by God's grace. It took me 7 years and it's not my own. It's a rented apartment, guys. So first tip is keep your starry tantrums at home and
okay.
have a lot of money in your pocket. And if you don't, just adjust. That's
okay.
the thing I want to give. That's like a very, I don't think so anybody will give you that advice. Adjust until you make it. Beggars are not choosers. So if
okay.
you're finding a decent room in a 2 BHK mm-hmm. flat on a sharing basis in your budget, take it. Do not think about it. Ki, arre, main kisi ke saath kaise rahungi ya rahunga. Because that's what struggling is all about. And
mm-hmm.
if your parents are really helping you, then
mm-hmm.
be thankful to them. Because it's a very
okay.
tough situation to survive in. Some days you might have to just eat vada pav and live.
Okay.
Secondly,
okay.
I would say, if you've come here, do not waste even a minute. Don't waste even a single minute. Have a schedule. 7 a.m. if you're waking up, go for your workout, come back and make a calendar for your day. There are so many people I've seen, Dil Nawaz, who come here, waste their 2 years, 3 years, give their parents money and go back. Why? I mean, why? You've come here for a reason. So try to fulfill that. And
okay.
the third thing, don't hesitate to ask people for help. Be a go-getter, as I said. Go out. If there's an audition going on, your friend is going for, just go with them. Zyada-zyada kya hoga, rejection hoga na. It's okay. And I want to give one more point in this, fourth point.
Go ahead.
Be mentally prepared and mentally strong.
Okay.
Because there will be days when there will be a lot of rejection. There will be days when you will not have people around you. There will be days when your friends will be not here. Like for example, right now, I give my situation. It's during this COVID situation, there are so many people, especially friends of mine, they left Mumbai because there's no work. And I'm totally alone here. But I'm trying to survive here. Yeah, I don't have any friends here.
Okay.
Everybody left. All my friends, all my close ones, all my near and dear ones, parents who are in Delhi. My friends also left because there's no work. Mentally, so many people are being stressed.
Right.
But you have to be mentally really strong if you want to come here. Or else don't come. Agar aapko ghar baith ke rona mujhe kaam nahi mil raha, mat aao.
Theek hai. Okay. So let's talk about COVID, Kanisha, because from the skill set point of view, because we were continuing the conversation from the skill set point of view, learning and failure point of view, I think COVID has technically reset everything and kind of it has taught us a new way of living, right?
Yeah.
What do you think changed post-COVID in industry? What kind of transformation has occurred? What change has occurred? And again, what are your tips or what are your advice to people now coming to Mumbai or thinking of getting into this industry post-COVID?
A lot has changed, Dil Nawaz. There is no work for people in this industry right now.
Okay.
Like, I'll give you an example. So we have spot boys on our set who actually serve tea to people, who serve food. Basically, they help. They're like the domestic helps on set. People are not having any spot boys right now. And there are so many of them asking us, ki, ma'am, kuch kaam de do, kuch kaam de do. I have so many friends who have gone back home because they don't have work. So the whole industry has changed. Of course, the shoots are happening now. The work has started happening. Touch wood, I am one of those few people who have a job here in this industry. So I feel blessed. So there are so many people who are just going back home because kaam nahi hai. Or if you shoot start bhi hua hai na, the strength of the crew is only like 20-25 people. So because of that, sabse pehle to costume designers ka cut ho gaya kaam. There are no makeup artists on set. There are no
okay.
sport boys on set. So the crew has come down. Yes, of course, actors are coming back to set and getting work. But I'll tell you what, only those actors who have TV shows or working since before have work right now. People who are looking for it, they don't have work, and there's no, not even a chance of getting work. So the whole industry has changed. But I'll tell you, the industry which has boomed for all of us, influencing okay. industry has, yeah, of course, they're paying lesser since before mm-hmm. because it's a pandemic. But everybody wants to work on their brand, and who's getting money?
Right.
Influencers.
Right.
So I think
right.
influencing is one industry. Social media is one industry which has boomed during this time.
COVID has also pushed a lot of stuff into digital. How do you see this transformation?
I would say that COVID has actually been fruitful for a lot of content creators, because
okay.
people are just sitting home and creating content every now and then. I myself created 2 short films which has won awards in Quarantine Film Festival. So this
Whoa.
Has been great for people who are making online content, because everybody's free right now. Everybody's free right now, and they are just watching things, watching films. And in fact, since there are no theaters, people are releasing their films online. So
right.
online industry and online channels are booming right now. And there's not only OTT platforms. People have started making their YouTube channels. There are so many influencers, people coming up and booming online. There are so many content creators. People who have just been, probably doing a job, have now become content creators. Why? Because
yes.
there's so much free time. So it has been a great shift towards this online.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think of course digital has kind of been taken to the next level, right? Because people now have more time and less clutter in their life,
bigger
right?
Bigger films are coming online. Bigger films are releasing on platforms like Hotstar,
yes.
Prime, Netflix. So Netflix announced 16 films last month.
Okay.
16 films in 1 month. I mean, can you beat that?
And this would have not been possible without COVID, of course.
Exactly. I'm
right.
sure those films must be releasing on theaters, but abhi tak to pata hi nahi hai theater kab khulenge. So people
right.
rather just sell their films and release them.
What exactly is social media influencing? Let's start with the basics.
Okay. So social media influencing is actually like you influence people to buy something. So
okay.
there is a set of audience which follow you and they listen to you. So when you promote a product, they will buy it or not, but they will listen to you. So for them, you're an idol, basically.
Okay.
So
okay.
nowadays, as social media is the new big thing, especially during this COVID time, a lot of brands are wanting influencers to tell, because you know, if an actor tells something, people might not listen, but an influencer who's just like a normal person like them tells them to buy something, they will definitely listen. I myself has, experienced this. There are so many people who DM me and ask, "Are ye product acha rahega kya? You tell us, what should we buy?
Oh.
Is
oh.
this good for the skin? Is this good for acne? Is this good for hair?" So a common person who's just like you and me, who's telling them, you know, buy this, people will listen. But you should have that power to tell people what to buy. Social media influencer is somebody who review products, who try something on themselves. Basically, they are guinea pigs. They are the people who try products on themselves. In short,
okay.
tell their audience the right thing for them. Yeah.
Okay. So my next question was that how do you become a social media influencer? What is the way of becoming? So if somebody wants to be a social media influencer, what is the first thing they should do?
Okay, there's a secret I'll tell you guys, which I have never told anybody. I myself, being an actor, I wanted to be a social media influencer since very long, because I used to see my friends getting free products. I started it for fun. चलो यार ये तो मजेदार चीज है, इसमें फ्री प्रोडक्ट्स मिलते हैं, लेट्स डू इट. सो व्हाट आई डिड इज आई स्टार्टेड कॉन्टैक्टिंग ब्रांड्स माय सेल्फ ओनली. लाइक व्हेन आई रीच 10,000 फॉलोअर्स, आई जस्ट स्टार्टेड मैसेजिंग द ब्रांड्स, यू नो, आई एम एन एक्टर, आई वांट टू रिव्यू योर प्रोडक्ट एंड आई विल डू अ पोस्ट फॉर यू, ऑल दैट. एंड या सम ऑफ देम रिप्लाइड, सम ऑफ देम डिड नॉट रिप्लाई, एंड द वंस हु रिप्लाइड मी, दे सेंड मी लाइक अ हैम्पर और अ सैंपल और व्हाटएवर. And slowly and steadily, I started getting into the group of influencers. I was added to some groups on WhatsApp, on Instagram.
Oh, okay.
And we used to exchange collaborations with each other. Abhi ye chal raha hai, wo chal raha hai. The good thing about being a social media influencer is people are not jealous. Of course, there are people who are jealous, but they share things with you. Right. People will never share a audition with you. That's the best thing. It's like a community. You help each other grow. So that's how I became an influencer. And if you guys want to start,
is it because of the nature of the job? Because in acting there's only one character and there are five people fighting with the same. But then in terms of branding, in terms of social media, I think one product can be given to 100 people and it can then amplify their volume, right?
Okay. Also, because you know, Dilnawaz, when two people go together to make content, they can help each other shoot. I feel
right.
That's one big thing. While as an actor, you have the whole crew shooting for you. So you save a lot of money.
So influencing is more of a community.
It's like a community. You help each other grow.
Absolutely, super. So again, like, how do you get 10,000 followers? Like, how what do you need to do?
Follow your following. I would just say keep creating good content.
Okay.
And just take care of the content you're creating, and put nice hashtags with a certain amount of hashtags. You really have to be careful about that. And I think then probably you can, even if you get 5,000 followers, somehow start messaging brands. There are influencers of all category. There's a micro category. I'm in macro category. So I'm in category B. Priyanka Chopra, Kylie Jenner, and everybody's in category A. So there are different categories of all. And
You work with a few famous brands as well. You named a few of them, Amazon, Nikon, likes of those, right? So how do you get such deals when you start working with such brands? Do you reach out to them? They reach out to you? How does this entire deal flow happens?
So there are a lot of PR agencies nowadays, like how there are casting agents for acting. I'm sure people are more aware of that. As an influencer, there are PR agencies who contact you. So initially, I used to just fill a form probably, which used to circulate. As I said, that I used to contact brands myself. But slowly and steadily, these PR agents started calling me. When they got my number and when they understood that, she's also an influencer, she's a working influencer. So they started contacting me, and sometimes when you see your friend has done a particular brand, you also ask them, please help karna mujhe. So that's how I got Nykaa. I asked one of my friends that I really want to do this brand. So then I send them my PR kit. So we influencers, like how actors have portfolios, we influencers have something called media kit or a PR kit. So where we write everything down on how many followers we have, what all social media platforms we are on, and what all collaborations we have done, what all brands we have worked with, and statistics of our insights and everything, which goes to PR agencies. And then those PR agencies contact us if they feel that a particular brand wants an influencer like this.
Okay.
But I would say your content is the thing. You need to really work on your content. Eventually, you're a content creator. More than an influencer, you're also a content creator. So just work on your content, and eventually, good brands will contact you.
So which word do you prefer for yourself? Do you prefer yourself as a content creator, or you prefer yourself as an influencer?
I'm both, but I prefer as a content creator, because it gets everything. Influencer. Okay. Actor, director, writer. So I'm a content creator. I create content on different platforms.
Okay. So you're majorly a content. You're a digital content creator, basically. That is digital how you kind of told. How was your kind of family? Were they supportive, not supportive? And how you managed it all?
I would say that I am one of few people, touch wood, who's so blessed that her family has always been very supportive. Even if I was touching the wrong button. My family, I am sorted in that sense as in. But initially when I was starting off, even my family was not very convinced. So when I got my first show, first film, as I told you in Delhi, it released and everything. Even after that, my family was not very convinced. They were against me going to Mumbai. So they took me to US. There's a brother of mine living in US, and he brainwashed me somehow. But it was for my well-being. He told me, why don't you stay here, get an internship? I was just finishing college that time. So why don't you get an internship, stay here with me in US? It's such a good place to live, all that jazz was happening. But I had made up my mind that I am going to be an actor. So he also asked me that, what's your next 5-year plan? In next 2 years, what are you going to do? Are you going to achieve it in 2 years? So when I told you back when we started this conversation, always give yourself only 2 years. That's what I've learned from him. Only give yourself 2 years. If it's not happening, it's not happening. Guys, you need to understand. So I know it's a struggling industry, but that's what I feel. So family plays a very important role. My family was very supportive of me, and even today they are. My parents are always the first ones to comment on my any post or any thing I do, films I do.
Okay, that's interesting.
They're like my biggest fans, I would say. So
okay.
My father goes to all my film festivals and award functions. He is really intrigued. He goes on set with me. If like I was shooting in Nainital 2 years back for a film, he went on set with me. He stayed there for me 3-4 days, and he enjoyed. He, main heroine ka papa hoon. So he really enjoys it because I feel that my parents have not been able to achieve what they wanted because of strict parents.
Right.
So they always tell me, what we did not get, we want you to achieve. So my parents have been very supportive that way, and touchwood, I think that's the reason I'm here. But you're absolutely correct that it's very important for family to support you. And if your family is not supporting you, then you might, be in a jeopardy whether you should do it or not. But I would just suggest to all the parents, if you are watching this, give your children a chance. Give your child a chance. Tell them to just take 1 year or so, and if they don't achieve anything in that 1 year, they will come back. At least they will not have a regret that their parents stopped them.
Right, so, absolutely.
Yeah. And if you guys still want to go against your parents' wishes, guys, I would say, if you have certain amount of money, don't go against them. Try to tell them that, okay, I will take 1 year. I'm going to prove myself in 1 year. If I don't prove myself in 1 year, I'm going to come back. Try to explain this to them. And I think you will be much more happier, and so will they be. So yeah.
Any more inputs from your side, or any suggestion from your side to finding a middle ground? So how do you manage to find a middle ground? Yeah, with parents, yeah.
So when it comes to parents and finding a middle ground, I would just suggest that try to explain them, give me 1 year or 2 years, and don't spend too much money on me. Take a certain amount of budget from them and tell them that I want to do this, and this is where my happiness stands. And I'm sure they're your parents, they will understand. But don't take too much time. Just ask them for a year or so. And I have realized that with time, then a lot of parents actually understand this, Dindavas. There are so many friends of mine whose parents have been really strict, but they let them come here and try in, such unconventional industries, because they tell them, ki main timeline lunga ya timeline lungi. And they actually stand by it. If they don't do anything great, they go back. Parents bhi khush, aap bhi khush.
But and I'm sure,
but
I think
another thing, which is a very, very funny thing, I would say, tell them I'm going to MBA. Sorted.
Okay. That's a cool hack. People should start trying that. I think that's a cool hack.
There's another thing, Dilnawaz, which you can do is you can take a part-time job here, like how people do it abroad. You can, start casting or probably take up a part-time job in an office or something, so that you can survive. And you can also tell your parents, ki, I am earning my certain sort of work. I have seen people working in restaurants here. They're doing acting, but part-time they work as, as a waiter or as a manager or something. Survival ke liye karna padta yaar. If people can do it abroad, why can't we do it here?
Now I'll, Kanisha, pick up a few more questions and then we'll navigate and then wrap accordingly. Which people or books have had the most influence on your growth?
People or book?
Which people or book? Like any, you can maybe talk about both, whatever you feel like, Kanisha.
So I don't read much, to be honest.
Okay.
I am more of a watcher. I watch films, and I have grown watching quarantine Tarantino's films. And he's my favorite director. And when I talk about direction, I somehow thought to myself that one day I'll make a film like him. So that's how I started doing behind the camera thing.
Okay.
And whenever I'm also making a film, I always make sure to do a breakup, like how he used to do in his films. So I've read a lot of articles from him. I've read a lot of interviews of him. So yeah, he's one filmmaker I really follow. And
okay.
Other person who I genuinely follow and want to be like is Priyanka Chopra. She is my idol. She is somebody,
okay,
like how she does everything and with such an ease. That's how I want to be in future. Like I want to do, I'm still doing things by with ease, but that's how I want my life to be. Like doing things with ease and mastering all the industries. There is a criteria for every campaign. Like for example, if a brand is paying you a certain amount, they would also want you to have certain sort of followers and certain kind of content. So things I want you to keep in mind is A, take care of your engagement. We guys are in a lot of engagement groups also. So we get engagements from that. We help each other grow, as I said before. Take care of your content. Try that your content is different from others. And how will you do that? Research. Mm-hmm. And yeah, you need to have a certain sort of followers. Like for example, there's a slab. 10,000 to 50,000 followers, there'll be a different sort of slab for people. Then 50,000 to 100K, there'll be a different sort of slab. And then so on and so forth. It's not about how many likes you should have, more about how many followers you should have and what kind of
content. So there's another question. He says that, sir, please ask Kanisha ma'am if influencers have full creative control over how they present the product to the audience, or that will be told by the brand that approaches you. So I think now it leads me to the content.
Yeah. That, brands have the campaigns. Like for example, abhi jaise friendship se nikla. So brands told us ki aisa certain sort of content hona chahiye. So they will give you referencing. So on that basis, you have to create content. But sometimes
So there are guidelines basically.
There's a guideline. But sometimes, like if it's a new brand or if they don't know about things, they will give you the creative call ki, please you do the content and do something nice for us. So then the creative call is in your hand. But if there is a campaign which is happening and a brand has given you guidelines, you need to send your content for approval. Then they will tell you if it's okay or not okay. You take the creative call, but if there is a change, they will let you know about it and then you can re-edit and send it.
So there's a proper management in place which runs everything together and then you kind of cross check it.
Eventually the content is going to be on your page and if it's a campaign based thing, sometimes they will also repost it. So they want it to be in a certain way that they can also post it on your page. Like for example, there are brands who have asked me to make something and I have posted it. Now, there are few things which they want to post on their page, but I have not created the content accordingly. So they asked me to recreate the content just for their page specifically because they want to feature me. So
How did you venture into web series and what kind of series do you do?
As you know that web series is the new big thing and there are so many auditions happening for web shows lately. So as an actor, I have, for somebody like me who speaks well and who looks tall and broad and all that, who has the real touch of probably Delhi or somebody like that, or for me, I am, somebody like me is in too much demand for web series because we look real. So they want people who are real. Yeah. You, me, anybody can be part of a web show if we look real and if we we can act well. So there was demand of actors who can act well in web shows and I started auditioning for it. And yeah, I got my first web show called Bombay by the same director who gave me role of my in my first film when I was 18.
Okay.
So I acted in his web show, then I started auditioning for more web shows and that's how I, you know, how I ventured into it. As a producer, as a director, I am still venturing into it. I started pitching to brands and pitching to channels. So slowly when I was working as an actor, that's how I actually realized that I want to start working in a web show and I want to start making one. And that's how I made contacts.
So what about the short film part, Kanisha? Like, is a short film different than a web series? Because of course, technically they are. But what about the short film? Like, and what's your preference? Do you do short films more or do you do web series more? What's the preference there?
So web series is actually a bigger sort of a thing because it's a series. It needs more budget. It needs more actors. It needs a bigger crew. While in a short film, short films can be made at home with a minimal budget and with a minimal cast, you just need to have a good story. So the company I'm working in, I'm making many more short films for them also right now.
Okay.
And I keep making that because short films, I think, is an inspiration. It's like a 5-minute thing. web series is a bigger thing. Sometimes people watch it, sometimes they don't. Like, if they get hooked to an episode, then only they will watch it. Short films are only 5 to 10 minutes, so anybody can take out time. So I really feel that making short films is much more beneficial for me. But if you want to earn money, then it's web series, of course.
It's web series. So okay, that's so Kanisha, I will wrap this now. Thank you so much from our side for joining us today on the show. And, you know, just really, really thankful for taking out time, coming here, talking about so many things. I think it was really nice listening to somebody who comes from such a diverse background. I'm sure we'll have more such interesting conversations with you in the coming, you know,
months. Thank you so much for having me. It was great talking to you. You're a great host and I enjoyed it.
Thank you so much.